back, everybody. I'll be all right. Must press on. Must try and be upbeat for show business reasons.
Yes, part of me still is a little bit Dakota Fanning. Anyway, my first guest tonight, a very good friend of this show, a very talented actor. He's starring in Welcome Home, Roscoe Jenkins, which is in theatres now. Take a look at this.
Good Lord. Michael Clarke Duncan, everybody.
Kind of cool.
You look fantastic.
I'm glad. You know what? It's been too long for me and you. You know that, man.
Yeah, what's happening? Where you been?
Oh, congratulations first.
On what?
Being a citizen of the United States of America.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Now what's wrong with Scotland? Why didn't you? What's wrong with Scotland?
Nothing wrong with Scotland. I live here in America. I'm not declaring war on the Scottish people or anything like that.
But when you go back there and they say, what are you, man? What are you going to say?
Well, first thing I'll say to them is, why are you using that ridiculous Pakistani accent?
That was a good one. That was a good one.
No, it was pretty good, actually.
I thought that was pretty good.
I don't know I don't know if they'll be bothered by it or not. I better not go back.
No, you should. Yeah. No, you better stay here.
Just in case. Yeah, yeah. You're an American.
You're sick tonight, man.
I am. Yeah, I've got the flu medication.
You know what you have to learn how to do? You have to be more aggressive. You have to start saying, look, I'm sick. Uh-huh. I'm not coming in.
Well, I said that, and they said, fine, then don't ever.
Then don't. Right. You have to stand. You play that ace.
Yeah.
That's what you throw down. You live with it. What can they do? What are they going to do?
No, throw me out of the job.
No, so? Tell them so. Just say so. Just do your hand like they do it.
So?
That's all you got to do, man. You got to be more
aggressive.
You're
right. Good night, everybody.
Let's go. That's right. Get out of here, man.
Did you do that? Have you ever done that with a job? Have you ever said, right,
I worked when they finished cement on the sidewalks.
Yeah.
And a guy fired me one day.
What?
So I marched right through the wet cement, gave everybody triple overtime. I went out with a bang.
Yeah.
You gotta start. You said, worldwide pants, we are out of here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's terribly funny.
No, we're out of here.
We're not. We're good. Everybody's fine. Knock it off. I think is interested in this movie that you're doing this, you're doing that scene we just saw there, right?
Yeah.
And you used to be his bodyguard.
Yeah, I used to work for Martin Lawrence.
That's weird. Is that weird when you go back and?
No, it's kind of cool now because he can't tell me what to do.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got a big trailer too and, you know, everything. But it was actually very funny because he remembered me from being his bodyguard. And he said I was the only person he wanted to play that role. So actually worked out perfectly.
That is very, very. No, you were a bodyguard. You did a lot of that kind of stuff before you became a movie star, didn't you?
Yeah, I love doing bodyguard work, man.
Really? I mean, do you get in at fights and stuff like that? Really?
I did.
Right. No, I'm guessing.
I didn't. I could talk a person out and get him outside and... You know, little bitty guys you have problems with. Nobody your size.
But trust it, me, I'm not going to attack you in any way, shape, or form.
Well,
I'll
sure?
use my weapons, sarcasm and charm.
Right, that's how you get a hit. That's how you got here.
Tell me about the movie. What's it about?
Roscoe Jenkins, played by Martin Lawrence, he comes back home. And he's a big Hollywood star. He's a big Hollywood star now.
Like you, for example.
Yes,
exactly. Yeah.
Wow, that's amazing.
When you go back home, is it similar to what happens in the movie?
No.
What happens then?
It's no fanfare. Nobody, you know, I don't get nothing. You know what the mayor gave me when I went back home? True story. Went back home to Chicago. First of all, they gave Tom Cruise a big plaque, Best Actor. And I'm like, well, okay. Well, I know I'm getting something. I'm from Chicago.
You know, Best Actor?
Yeah, Best Actor in Chicago.
Is that like Chicago slang for craziest guy we've ever seen?
Probably.
Yeah,
but they still
right.
gave it to him.
All right, okay.
So I'm thinking, okay, I know the mayor, Mayor Daley, so I know I'm getting some. He has in my room when I come back a book of Chicago.
Oh, yeah.
A book, like if somebody gave you a book of Scotland.
Yeah, yeah.
You're like,
been there, been there, been there, been there, yeah.
You couldn't give me anything, a plaque or something to say, you know.
Well, what would you like your plaque to say? We'll get a plaque run over here. I'm sure we can do it.
One of Chicago's finest actors or something.
All right,
you know
okay.
What
about Chicago's finest actor?
That too.
All right.
Chicago's finest.
What part of Chicago are you from?
South Side. Represent the South Side.
Right. Okay. Is that a pleasant area?
No.
Okay.
It is now.
It is now.
It is now. But when I was coming up, it wasn't very pleasant.
Right. Was it tough? Was it tough in the streets? Did you have to fight your way two-fisted all the way to Hollywood, where you became lactose intolerant and all kind of stuff like that?
You're real sick tonight, aren't you?
I'm very sick tonight.
Yeah, I can tell, man. No, actually. I got into a couple of fights. My mother kind of showed me how to defend myself. My sister was the brawler, though.
Right.
My sister was the one who could take on anybody.
Yeah.
And I was kind of like, yeah, him.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, it's him. And she would go beat him up.
So. Does she ever do any bodyguard work now, or does she?
No. No, not now.
Hey, did you watch the Westminster Dog Show? And if you did you enjoy the testicle squeezing?
I like Uno. Uno's cool.
Yeah,
I got
two
dogs at home.
You got two dogs?
Lucy and Matrix. A German Shepherd is Matrix and a Rottweiler named Lucy.
I have a German Shepherd.
Do you? They're
yes,
the
I
coolest
do.
Dogs.
Very, very farty.
Are you a dog?
Yeah.
You know what? I hate that. Because when people come over to the house, they... Thank you. They always look at me. It's the dogs doing that, but you can't tell people that.
No, and also German shepherds, German, like to march during the night. You know?
That sort of thing, huh? You know what? That's true, though.
It is. Do you have any snakes or budgerigars?
I used to have a snake. What was it last week?
A budgerigar. It's like kind of like a small parrot.
A budgerigar?
Yeah, I'm really pretty high right now.
Right, you are. Budgerigar.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I've never heard of a budgerigar.
That's a real thing.
A budgerigar. No, I've never heard of...
Ask Davis. Davis will tell you. He's right.
I do have a chinchilla named Chucky, though. Chinchilla.
A chinchilla?
Named Chucky.
What's a chinchilla?
You know what they make the nice fur coats and stuff
you
out of?
You can't do that with your pets.
No, I don't. Don't get Peter started on me, okay? No, I don't. Chucky is cool.
Do you have any cats?
5 cats.
Oh, stop.
As Pinky,
right.
Bunny, Snowflake, Whiskers, and Big Papa. Big Papa's a little overweight. He's a little overweight.
That surprises me somewhat.
Right.
I didn't have you down as a cat guy.
No, I love cats. I have cat all my life, man.
Right, but so you've got 5 cats, 2 dogs, and a chinchilla.
Yes, and fish.
And fish?
Yeah.
Do you ever feed the fish to any of the other animals?
That was cool.
I told you. No.
I love my little animals.
All right, okay. What kind of fish do you have?
They're koi fish.
Koi, they're delicious. Michael,
what kind of man are you?
I'm a man that enjoys a fish dinner, is what I am.
Don't be that way with my animal. No, my fish are nice.
All right. But your koi is a delicious fish.
No,
have you ever been to the restaurant Koi here in Beverly Hills?
Once.
Right.
They do not serve koi at Koi. Don't do that. Because I've only been there once, and I'll never go back if that's what I think. Please don't put that in my mind.
All right. They don't serve koi. Have you ever been to the restaurant Chinchilla here in Ireland?
You will make me upset. Chucky is nice.
Right,
Chucky is cool. Leave Chucky alone.
No, it's all right.
Leave my
it's
animals
all right.
alone.
It's all right. What about that? Are you still at the yoga? Are you still doing the yoga stuff?
Yeah, you should take Bikram yoga.
I like the yoga. What's the Bikram yoga? What's that?
It's the hot yoga. You're in the room, it's 100 degrees.
Yeah.
Really good for your joints and everything. Clears your mind up. You would not have that cold if you did more yoga.
Well, you know who was here last night? Susan Sarandon was here last night. She said,
Beautiful.
You would not have the flu if you looked after yourself better. And I'm like, I look after myself fine.
You don't. You don't.
Come on.
You don't. I have yet to get sick.
I eat as much koi as I can get my hands on. I'm kidding. I don't. I would never eat a delicious koi.
I'm going to walk out of here.
No, I know.
I'm the only guest you got tonight. You know I'm the only one. I'm the only guest tonight, okay? If I leave, the show shuts down. Don't piss me
Michael,
off
Michael, so tell me about the movie.
Tell me about the movie. Listen to what I got to talk
all
about.
Right.
I want to talk about my movie
now. Tell me about the damn movie.
You know, matter of fact,
what?
I don't like your attitude, and I want to sit in that seat.
Oh, come on, man.
I want to sit in that seat. Right. I want to sit in that seat. Now, I'm taking over.
All right.
Yeah, that's right.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a fun show tonight, and my first guest, he's a comedian straight out of Scotland. It's Craig Ferguson!
Hi, everybody. But Interesting you should say that, Michael, because we have to take a break. We'll be right back with the North Mississippi All-Stars. We'll be right back, everybody.